Previously on Minecraft Survivor, Saints vs. Sinners. Thermal was recovering from being dingle-snorfed at the Neptune vote. Boston attempted to rekindle the fire with Madison after lying to her about his vote. Kyle, Kimmy, and Red formed a Big Threats Alliance in order to keep themselves safe in the game.
You know, why don't we just make a Big Threats Alliance?
At the challenge, Jeffel showed great skill and won immunity. Back at camp, everyone seemed to find a common enemy, as Thermal was totally alone in the game. Thermal continued to fight, but in the end, it was him who saw his torch snuffed. Who'll be joining the jury tonight? Find out now on Minecraft Survivor, Saints vs. Sinners.
Oh man, I'm sweating. That was such a close vote. Psych, man. How'd that even happen? I mean, I thought it was gonna be like 4 or 5, but unanimous. Yikes, Thermal. That's crazy that you were such an obvious pick to have in the end, taking up someone else's spot. They'd rather have me over you. That's great. Every single person. I'm a little dumbfounded by how well that went. We always know what happens in Survivor. When something goes really well, something's bound to go very poorly afterwards.
Ready to win this game?
Oh, fuck yeah. I don't care if it's me. If it's you or me, I don't give a fuck.
I agree. It's going to be a hard ride to the end. Because mm-hmm. We kind of just have each other. But, see how it goes. Maybe we're not big threats anymore.
Hopefully not. I'm just chilling eating my tzatziki.
I know. How many votes do you think I'll get next tribal?
The world may never know. Not until it happens. Let me see. What is this, final 7?
Yeah, so probably...
I say
probably 3.
2. 1, 2. Anywhere from 1 to 3.
Yeah, anywhere from 1 to 3. Because I can't go home, right?
So, I'm honestly beyond ecstatic, like, how the last vote went. You cannot tell me that I'm not doing something right, considering my name was out there, but it was still unanimous. Didn't get one vote to my name. I'm feeling so fucking good. But at this point, it's time to exterminate one last rat. And I think we all know who that rat is. Jeffels, it's your time to go. And honestly, it's going to be beneficial to me. And I'm going to do my best to convince everyone else that something that's beneficial for my game is good for theirs.
Oh my god, girl. I'm so glad we finally got him out.
Well, yes. Like, I'm so sorry, but like... Literally, after the flip-flop bullshit, I was just tired of that man. So I'm, like, glad that we could all, like, come together for, like, once in a blue moon and actually, like, do that.
I know. And, like, now, like, I'm really glad that we could, like, come together, like, even though we haven't necessarily been on the same side, that we could, like, come together and, like, work on something and...
Well, yes.
I think that we are gonna have to do that again. And I think it's time that we work together again and we get that little rat Jeff out.
Interesting. Clock it.
We're gonna clock his tea, girl.
I am still here somehow. I don't know why that was the first tribal that I did not receive a vote and I was vulnerable, minus the first one. So I'm a little shocked, like, I don't know how, but my group and I were able to shift the tides and get Thermal to go home. And I'm not gonna lie, some points that Madison brought up against Jeff is like very noticeable now. He wanted to vote off Madison for some random reason and was also okay with Kyle or Red going home. And while I have that deal for now, which is literally ending in 2 rounds, I need to keep them around so that I stay safe.
You want to take Kimmy, like final four, final three? Like, what about fucking?
I just think that she shouldn't be a target for the next few votes.
No, I'm down to keep her around. You know,
she's a force with us.
No, that's definitely fair. So who do you think we should go for then? Like a Maddie or a Kyle?
I didn't have an answer to your question.
Throughout this game so far, you know, Kimmy's had my back. I've kind of been under her wing, I'm not gonna lie. Same with Red. And you know, Boston's cool. Yeah, you know, they don't really have a reason to get rid of me, and I enjoy their company. I enjoy their presence.
I'm thinking that we gotta split up any like duo.
Like what? The Kimmy and Weiss one, or like the Kyle and Maddie one?
Kimmy and Weiss are a duo?
I mean, I thought they kind of were. Like, yeah. Honestly, it's kind of assumed, if I'm being real. It's kind of a throw out there.
I that's news to me. But I think we should split Kyle and Maddie.
I've put myself, I think, in the best spot I can possibly put in the game. I'm right now situated in the middle between two duos of Weiss and Kimmy, and the other duo of Kyle Madison, and with myself in Boston right in the middle of that. And I've been trying to keep this tension between these two groups where their guns are pointing at each other and just avoiding me. Because every single round, they keep wanting to vote each other out, but every single round, I prevent them from doing that.
So our thought process was that Maddie might try to just find people on the bottom or people with not much on their resume and then try to take over the game. We let her duo go any further, I think that she's more of a problematic person to keep around than Kyle for the moment, but I'm definitely willing to just listen to whatever you guys want me to do, honestly.
Okay. I mean, I'm shocked with the 7-1 vote. I was like, damn, okay.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, it's like, Kyle and Maddie are clearly a duo, right? I think we all have to be aware of this.
I
am honestly, for the first time in these 9-10 rounds, I feel content. A 7-1 vote, I never thought it would have happened. Like, I'm shook. I'm like, I can't believe that we actually managed to pull that off.
Welcome, Final 7, to your next Unity Challenge. Jeffel's gonna have back the necklace. Thank you.
Yeah, he'll get it back.
Immunity is back up for grabs for today's challenge.
You will complete 5 different tasks to retrieve numbers. The first task is a sand dig. The second task is a shulker wall. The third task is a chest search. The fourth task is a minecart push. And the final task is a ladder climb. Once you've done all 5 tasks, you will use your numbers and your clue book to decipher a code. First player to place the correct code on their board wins individual immunity.
All right, survivors ready? Go. Wise with a little bit of a slow start.
When does it stop? When does it stop?
Up, Boston has a lead. Red has overtaken him. This is Red in the lead with Boston in second. They are now looking for the number 3 and their minecart. Time on the third section. Now she's pushing her minecart. Kyle is still digging deep.
With Weiss.
Jeffels now is onto the search for the minecart. Madison, don't give up. You have not fallen out of this just yet. Look at you, Madison, moving on to the next section.
I've never done that before.
This minecart push is not easy. Red and Kimmy are very close.
Red has completed his minecart push. He's moving on to the fifth and final section. People in this challenge, although Red is struggling with the ladder wall more than he probably should, giving Kimmy time to catch up.
Oh my gosh, I'm actually trolling.
This is now dead even for first place, and no one is out of it. Both have gotten the number 5 and their clue book at the same time. This is truly neck and neck.
I'm throwing up. Jesus Christ.
They might struggle on this logic puzzle, so nobody is out of it. Jeff, moving on to the logic puzzle.
Oh, that's
finally.
Check.
Incorrect.
That's check.
Watch.
And Kimmy has won.
Oh my god.
Individual immunity.
My god, I won a puzzle.
All right, Kimmy. Your second immunity win of the season. Come get the necklace.
God, fuck you.
And with that, Kimmy has secured a spot in the final 6 of Saints versus Sinners. The rest of y'all, you have to fight to get there. We'll see what happens. Head back to camp.
I won immunity. I'm in the final 6. Oh my god. Like, I am not known for my puzzle abilities, but I know that I made up a lot of lost time from that parkour, and winning against Red is a little delicious, I can't lie. I know we're targeting each other at Final 5, and that's coming up soon, so I'm feeling pretty good.
So what do we think is the best move here?
I mean, that's, I don't know. Question. It's like, y'all mentioned that Jeffels is also someone who's really in the middle.
It's true. It is really true.
And, I mean, he was kind of on the same terms as Thermal and Neptune. Theoretically, he could be somebody who would be, I mean, an option to go home.
Could be with that. Could definitely be with that.
Oh, we have a perfect plan to get to Final 6 and Final 5 and beyond. Like I said, having Neptune and Thermal flip on me was kind of the best thing that could happen for me in this game. It opened up all my avenues. No one sees me as the guy with all the puppets. It's now like, oh, that guy just gets votes every time, so we can take him out at any point. Well, you better do it better sooner rather than later, because you can keep saying you can get me out at any time, but when it gets down to it, you might not be able to.
I think it's a long fucking time coming, I'm gonna be honest.
I just know y'all are fuming with this man.
He's just frustrating, and the fact that he came up to me was literally like, yeah, I don't think we're gonna be voting together anymore.
What? Wait, he actually did that?
Yes! Yeah, and I was like, oh?
Oh my god. Yeah, I mean, honestly, the drive is there, so I'm down for whatever y'all want. I'm not gonna lie. At first, I was a bit hesitant about working with Kyle and Maddie. We've not talked most of the game, but the more I'm thinking about it, the more this benefits me. If Jeffels does go home, then he's the strongest person outside of the three-person deal. Myself and Red are still set up to do a tie vote and get out potentially Kyle, which, no shade, I feel a bit more inclined to target Red at final six. I am still in the game, obviously. I still have allies. Kyle and Madison would trust me more, so I don't want to betray Jeffels, but again, you have to be cutthroat in this game, and if you can't respect that, I don't know what you can do.
So here's my line of thinking, right?
Yeah.
Jeffels, Kimmy, and like Weiss, if we don't break up that three here at the final seven, mm-hmm. like we're kind of fucked. Like we have, like Kimmy has all the power over us both right now, especially if we go like with the final five plan. So I do feel like we need to cut our legs off a little bit here.
Oh yeah.
Just, we like take out like absolutely. Jeffels or something.
I agree. I mean, they've been a three. I mean, they were a four with B, and they haven't been touched since B went home.
I know.
I agree. I mean, if my
Maddie,
if,
we talk
yeah,
to
Maddie, Maddie would be down.
The other guy, boss. We talked to boss. This vote, I really need to take out Jeff here, mostly just because of the fact that he has told me multiple times that he is with Kimmy, and I can't have that. I feel like he would choose Kimmy over me, and I need to make sure Jeff goes home here. I need to cut off Kimmy's legs here and take out Jeff.
Hey.
Okay. So what are you thinking?
I'm thinking Jeff.
You're thinking Jeff?
Kimmy said that she'd be down with it. Kimmy's the one who brought it up.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what about Red?
I don't know. It's so long overdue, and he's gonna comp out.
Who?
Fucking Jeff. Oh my goodness, I'm not gonna lie to you. I am so over these people. Like, everyone's just, like, been kind of getting on my nerves, but it is what it is. I'm just hoping, like, if this vote goes the way it is supposed to go, then I think I'm gonna have a fucking smooth sail to final three. And I really want a final three with Boston and Kyle, so I'm keeping my fingers crossed because Kyle has been, like, my ride or die since the beginning. He's always been loyal to me. He's always voted for me. And Boston, like, he's just been always open with wanting to work for me, even though he did kind of, like, fuck me over right then and, at one of the tribal councils. Really didn't affect me too much, so I'm willing to work past it. And, yeah, we'll see what happens.
This needs to happen, though.
Yeah, dude, it has to be.
We need to vote together regardless of what we're doing.
Yeah,
so put,
like,
everything
three,
out on the table.
Yeah, that's six.
Nothing. Yeah.
The other three are the tightest three since merge.
Jeff has got to go. He's got to go. He's going to comp out. Kimmy's going to comps too. Jeff is going to comps. And I think Wes is kind of just like there. You know what I mean? Sticking with them. I'm not really worried about them.
I'm 100% down for this because, like, I found six. We literally, they have a strong three. And, like, we'd be
they
down.
They have a strong three. They're both.
I was
going to
say, if
really
one of them doesn't
players.
Go home, they just have a forced tie. And
they
if one of them
rocks.
Doesn't go
yeah,
home,
exactly.
It's one of us.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
I get together the four. Me, Boss, Kyle, and Madison. We're like, we need to vote together. We need one of the three gone. Let's go for Jeffels because Kimmy's a Mia. I'm like, perfect. This is what I want to hear. But then, even better, Kimmy all of a sudden now wants Jeffels out because she wants to keep in the shield of Kyle and Maddie as a duo. I'm like, Kimmy really is just cutting off her own leg. She does not. She's like on a deserted. She's like a castaway on a deserted island where she has all this food and water there, and she's just gnawing her own leg off right now. Why? I don't know. Conserving food, maybe? That's a terrible idea.
Between us, real quick, like, what do you think about final six? Like, are we really gonna let Red? Like, I was thinking, like,
he's also, that's that group. Jeff, Kimmy, Red, they're all really fucking good.
Red's already won twice. Like, Kimmy's won
same
twice.
As Jeff.
Like, Jeff's won once
two,
or twice.
Four, six. They've been basically fucking alternating individual immunity. So I think maybe moving forward next week, Red may be the bet if you want to do that.
I
well, because I can't see myself going into final three with him. I want to do you and Kyle.
I'm gonna be, like, real with you. If we take Red beyond final six, we're gonna get he's probably gonna win
Fucked.
Out, and he easily wins a jury vote. He's been the most active player in the game, easily.
What is Boston doing? Like, I want to make it to the final three. Me, Boston, and Kyle, us making it to the final three is like my main goal, because they're the two main people that I feel the most comfortable with in this game. And it's really frustrating me how Boston's saying he wants to be with me at the final three as well, but he's making my situation harder to get in there. Like, me getting Jeff out here would be so beneficial to me getting to the final three. This is my pathway, and I'm trying to pave it for me to get there. And all I need Boston to do is stop being so difficult. I have no problem voting out Red in the future. I don't want him in the final three. So getting him out next is something that I'm okay with doing. But right here, right now, I need Jeff out, and I will do whatever it takes to make sure he goes.
I feel like it's, we should probably do Maddie or Kyle here. I feel like that's just like, just break them up at least, you know?
Yeah.
I want to move solid with you guys going forward. And
no, 100%.
What's the biggest thing that might break us up is a duo. It's Maddie or Kyle.
I'm so down. Like, do you think Red and Kimmy would work with us? And like, we could possibly like split this vote. Honestly, like I'm really worried about an idol this vote. Like,
this is a 5-man split might be necessary here, but if one person flips, we're in trouble.
My dream final three, my best final three with Jeff and Wes. We had a conversation, and we're talking about potential targets. They both would prefer if a Madison or a Kyle went here, and and I was like, yeah, let's go along with it. But I push out my agenda on them, and I say, I think we should split the votes. I think we should split the votes here, and I think we can send out one of them here. That is just my strategy this season, is the split the minority. There is so many pros to splitting the minority, and I've been doing it almost every vote since the merge. You only need fewer votes to like pull off a blindside.
Red, do you think we'll be able to pull Kimmy?
I think we should. If we want to do a split vote, I'm down. I know we talked about that right before the last time, right before the challenge.
No, I think I'm all ears. I think Kimmy, I think she's down. I don't see her working with Kyle or Maddie, for this vote. It doesn't make any sense. And I don't see why we can't
not make it any further. I'm sorry.
No, if they make it one more vote, it gets like too dicey, because then one person flips and then it's like tied, and they'll go rocks. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah,
that's something that has to be split up. It's like, I have to get to the final three. It doesn't really matter who I'm sitting with. Like, I feel like I could pledge my case pretty well if I get there. I just need to be able to get there though. And I think waiting till six to get Red might earn me that, because if I take Red out at six, at five, I'm the swing vote once again between Kyle, Madison, and then Kimmy and fucking Wes.
If we play this right, we can be at finals together.
That's what I'm thinking. Like, genuinely, like, as long as everything goes to plan here, we're golden.
And I think we all have an equal shot too.
That's what I'm thinking. I feel like
it's really nice.
Yeah, agreed. Agreed.
I'm probably a bit more screwed because we'll have a bunch of bitter saints that don't want to vote me, but it is what it is.
Yeah. I feel like I'll talk to Kimmy and I'll see if she's down.
But yeah, I definitely want to move forward with you, and I'm glad that it's working out.
I am so happy for my girl Kimmy winning this immunity. I think this will definitely help us out, since obviously her name has been on the chopping block a few more times. That does worry me, because I feel like Kyle and Maddie could look at me as a possible option, but we're gonna hope for the best. These past two tribals have like gone the way I wanted them to, so I feel like this is like, I should not feel as content as I do, but like, it's fine. Like, I'm here for it. Either one going is fine. I feel like we're good.
It's just, I don't know. Like, do we think that Kyle has the idol, like, for sure?
Since that's what a lot of people think, but at the same time, I feel like, would he not have used it already?
If all of us stick the plan here, The problem is, like, I don't know if all of us are gonna stick.
I have some faith in the fact that for, you know, people like, for people like Kimmy and Red, who are, you know, big threats, they, not only do they kind of need to work with each other right now, they really need me. They will be absolutely, you know, cutting off their own legs, pretty much. And then attempting to run a marathon if they vote me off here. And so, that should be, that's two people who, you know, should be with me. And that's not enough for a split when there's four other people.
Maddie would be the safer option in case of an idol, but that's the only merit there is to voting Maddie here.
Yeah, so, like, I'm voting Maddie, where's everyone else voting?
I'm pretty sure that if we're voting, I can vote for Kyle, and then...
I'll vote Maddie.
Okay, so then you two vote Maddie, and then myself, Weiss, and Boston vote for Kyle. And if Kyle plays an idol, then Maddie goes home on the revote.
Oh yeah, Red, what did you hear?
Yeah, what's going
on? I mean, it was just, like, your name pretty much being said. I think, yeah. Kimmy, you're in the initial combo for, like, Jeffles, right? Like,
yeah, they definitely are a bit mad at you.
My goal this round is to pretty much keep myself in the middle of the vote in the next round. Because right now, I'm very concerned about my position getting exposed right now, where I'm trying to play both sides. And right now, people have been exposed for it. Jeffles got exposed, Thermal got exposed. And right now, me and my boy Boss, we've been kind of the two actually pulling these moves off and actually flipping the votes. Well, you know, Jeffles and Thermal have been more wishy-washy about every round. So we've been getting away with it a lot more. And right now, I'm trying to convince people to vote Jeffles out because Jeffles wants to take Kimmy to the end. Why would you want to take Kimmy to the end? I don't want to take Kimmy to the end. And that person is not good for my game, especially if Jeffles, Kimmy, and Whis team up in Final Six. So I gotta cut out Jeffles.
I really want to stay.
Yeah, of course, of course.
Like, I really want to stay. And I don't want to be eliminated after all this time because the same people that have been trying to rope me back in over and over pull something. Like, I don't want that after everything, like, Folk did for me and after everything, like, B did for me. Like, I don't want everything they did to be in vain when I'm trying to... I've made it obvious that I'm not going to work with those people.
I think we should probably keep with the split plan.
I'm really putting my fate in the hands of the people with, you know, in the hands of others. I'm really putting my fate in the hands of others. I really hope that them pitching me, like, doesn't work. It kind of upsets me a lot that, like, I don't know Kyle's thought process, but he keeps, like, throwing out my name to other people and then blaming me for not really being communicative. And I want to stay. And I really hope that the others see the sense to stay because a duo cannot make it any further in this game.
Am I the target?
I don't think so, but I mean, I guess I kind of understand.
Who would they target?
Probably you.
Yeah. And so if this falls through, you know who goes.
I hope not.
Should we just do Maddie here?
No, why Maddie? With this night, it's like I have my deal with like Kyle and Red, but also the thought of taking out Kyle is very tempting. Very tempting. So I don't know what to do. I mean, I know Kyle and Maddie are definitely against Jeffles, and I know that I'm definitely in the future planning on getting out Red and Kyle and potentially Maddie, I don't know. But again, it's a really difficult call, and this is the end game practically. Like, we are getting into the final four votes of this season, and I'll be damned if it's one of me.
Welcome back to y'all's next tribal council. Kimmy, second time you have Nicholas on, how's it feel?
Fucking great. I mean, it feels great, especially being at this tribal council where I'm very confused what is happening, but I'm just glad that I don't have to worry about going home for now.
Boston.
Yo!
There always comes a point in the game of Survivor where strategies start to change. You know, there's the pre-merge, then the early merge, then the middle part of the merge, and then the end game. Where do you see us right now, and how is that playing into what you're trying to do?
I definitely think we are transitioning into the end game. I feel like Final Seven's kind of like that turning point from like mid game to like end game where people are not really looking, like they're not, you know, like it's just not that much trust based. Like, yeah, trust is definitely a factor, but like at this point, you got to start thinking about who's going to be sitting at the end with you And if you're not thinking that far, then I don't know what the fuck you're doing, honestly.
Madison.
Hey.
If we look at the original tribe numbers, there are 4 centers and 3 saints left. Does that have any relevance to you, or is all that pre-merge tribe line BS out the window?
I think that pre-merge alliances were definitely important and did come into play when we did merge. But I think once we all got like used to it and everything, we kind of just, like my great-grandfather said, had to put our balls to the wall. Quote right. By him.
True.
So, no, I don't really think it has much relevance anymore because there's a lot of new alliances and all that.
Wise, do you believe that those bonds made early on at Purgatory between tribes has played into the recent votes, or do you think that it's truly just been random connections made at the merge?
I feel like it's kind of a mix of like both. Like I feel like the Purgatory bonds like weren't really that impactful. I don't know. I feel like we're good. I feel like everybody's kind of got their shit together. We've got the messy people out.
Jeffles, you were immune last round. However, this round you are not. Do you feel scared that you no longer have that security that you had going into the round before?
Short answer, yes. Long answer, it's nerve-wracking. You go from being safe to being not safe to, you know, having just a bunch of nonsense happen. And I hope I can make it past this vote because I think it's very beneficial for a lot of people to keep me.
Kyle, everybody that's played a Minecraft Survivor knows about that stressful feeling you get in your stomach whenever Tribal Council rolls around. Are you feeling that really big stressful feeling in the pit of your stomach right now at Tribal?
I think when you get voted as much as I do, that pit sort of becomes something you're used to. That pit's a friend. That pit is going to manifest itself into an ally, because the more you can overcome the stress of that pit and wrestle it down to the ground and make it familiar, that's a good thing. That made no sense at all, by the way. I just said it because I thought it'd be cool, and it was.
It was fucking badass.
It was fucking awesome.
Lastly, Red, this game is going to come down to a couple more votes, and challenges are important, allies are important, but the jury is also very important. What are your thoughts on how this jury's been constructed and if it's benefiting you or not?
Bro, honestly, I don't think it's benefiting me. I really haven't given too much thought to jury management or anything. It's probably on me, though, to be honest, but yeah, I don't think it's going well for me.
And with that, it is time to vote. Kimmy, you're up first.
You've served your purpose well, and I salute you, soldier.
Hopefully, we can get rid of this damn cockroach once and for all.
Another lamb to the slaughter. You lost the game when you put trust in me, I'm not gonna lie.
Jeff, it's been a long time fucking coming. Even though you're probably not gonna go, and I'm probably gonna get bamboozled or whatever the fuck that other guy was saying it's called.
I will go collect the votes. Alright, I've collected the votes. If anybody has hidden the media idol and would like to play it, now would be the time to do so. Alright, I will read the votes. First vote, Madison. Second vote, Jeffles. Third vote, Kyle. That's one vote Madison, one vote Jeffles, one vote Kyle. Four votes left.
How many tribal councils is this now?
I got so many fans.
Fourth vote, Jeffles.
Fifth vote, Jeffles.
Ugh.
Sixth vote. And the 10th person voted out of Soccer Talk Cup Survivor, Saints vs. Sinners, and the 5th member of our jury, Jeffles. That's enough.
Alright. Well, I have some things to say, if that's okay first.
That's fine.
It was fun. I don't think there's very much I could have done differently there, since that's 4 on me, but whoever stuck with me, I really appreciate it. I kind of saw it coming. And just Kyle and Madison, I know we had our differences, but I want you to know that I don't take anything personally, and I wish everyone the best.
Thank you.
Thanks, ma'am.
Same to you.
That's rough.
Jeffles, what a fun roller coaster to watch you on this season. It's been a blast having you. However, the tribe has spoken. It's time for you to go.
Adios, guys.
Thanks. Take care.
Where am I going? Like, am I killing myself?
Well, congratulations, you all, on making it to the final 6 of Saints versus Sinners. Who will come out victorious? We'll have to wait and see. Head back to camp.
Oh, shit.
My body is fucking aching.
I'm a bit sad that, you know, people made a lot of sacrifices for me, and I appreciate that. And, you know, Folk and B, if you're watching this, I really appreciate what you did for me. And anyone who stuck with me there, I really appreciate what you did for me as well. But I became too much of a threat, I think, and maybe something Kyle or Madison said got through, and, you know, there was not much I could have really done. And I'm okay with that. Thank you, Soccer. Thank you, all the cameras, everyone here who took a lot of time out of their day to, you know, come here and let us all play a really fun game.